You need to go there. I know, but it's our only option.
All right.
Adam, I was very surprised when I first met you.
Why?
Back in the colony, we learned that everyone on Earth was completely wiped out.
I'm sure it must have seemed that way. But you can't expect Mother Sphere to know everything.
Then there are other survivors out there, like you.
Yes, but it's rare to see them. Earth is still pretty inhospitable to humans. We're here.
Where's the transportation device?
Try activating this monorail panel. You have to reorganize the code in order to restore power. That's great. Try activating the monorail panel again.
Something is heading our way.
Don't worry. It's the monorail.
This ancient electronic device is our transport.
All right, then. After you. Are you all right?
Oh, I was just remembering something from yesterday. This city, it's so quiet and so lonesome.
Well, that's what happens when a city becomes devoid of humanity. Eve. What are you going to do after you defeat the Alpha Nativa?
All airborne squad members exist for one sole purpose. All we must do is complete the mission.
You mean the extinction of all Nativas? Right? To think that the point of your existence is to snuff out another species. No fun in that. We're here. Do you want to get off?
Looks like this used to be a plaza.
You're right. Except it's underwater now. The good thing is you won't have to go in the water. The Hall of Records is that way. It might be best to stay away from the water. Looks like there's electricity running through it.
Ah!
must be the control device for the floodgate. You can only activate it with the right credentials. Let's come back later. We have things to do. Shopping done.
Adam, do you meet airborne squad members from the colony often?
No, not really. Yesterday, I just happened to be around the area. I've never seen such a large-scale airborne operation.
Why did you save me?
I'm not really sure. It just felt right, like I was meant to. It's hard to describe. It's just a short, intense feeling. How about you try jumping and dashing?
What?
Nothing. Just talking to myself.
Need a four-digit password.
Another headache. Okay, this sign reads time. Could this be connected to the clock tower? Watch out! Are you okay?
It's nothing.
I can see the Hall of Records. We're almost there now. It's a victory monument. The Hall of Records is under there.
Yeah!
around the Victory Monument first. That's the code to the power control room. Great. Power has been restored. We'll head down to the Hall of Records now. I can't believe we're in the Hall of Records. It's like a dream. Now, all we have to do is find the hyperdrive.
At the start of the 22nd century, humanity's right to life was threatened by advanced global warming. Having foreseen this, Mother Sphere ensured mankind could meet this challenge. The eons-long process of natural adaptation resolved near instantly. The body cell replaced the heart and made it possible to survive in environments without oxygen or water. Thanks to advances in biotechnology and nanotechnology, the inconveniences of aging and disease were a thing of the past. This created giant leaps forward in the development of hazardous industrial spaces and space itself. We can now withstand the crushing pressures of the deepest oceans and even exit a space station without the need of a spacesuit. Humanity's greatest and only hope for survival can be found in Mother Sphere. Please, enjoy the harmony and prosperity of Eidos 7. The first city ever built by Mother Sphere, the mother of...
I have no idea what that was all about. Adam, did it make any sense to you?
Mankind's past was buried with the final war. This must be a video from before that time.
Hypercell. Is this what you're looking for?
Yes. You can extract it from the hyperdrive. Great. We accomplished our first objective. Let's go before the emergency power runs out. We got it. The hypercell. This is going to do a lot of good. Eve, thank you.
Okay. Then, can you tell me where the Alfenitiba is?
Of course. It isn't far. Just follow the path and go straight.
We've come quite far. How much more do we have to go?
We just have to pass that sewage facility. There must be a way to get across. We can build ourselves a bridge if we use that crane.
Question.
What is it?
The hypercell. If it sustained the Hall of Records until now, it must be a huge source of energy.
Yes. Even compared to a fusion cell.
Then where are you planning to use this energy?
Oh, well, it's kind of a long story. But I can explain more when you come back.
Understood. Loud and clear.
Try using the crane.
It's not working.
But there is power. That's strange. Oh, we need an ID card if we want to operate it. Three of them, actually.
If the ID cards are needed for the crane, then they should be nearby. I'll look for the closest one first.
Okay. You can take your time.
I wonder what it looked like before the war.
What do you think it looked like?
Well, probably upright buildings, well-manicured flora, and living people.
That's it? You have no imagination. Then again, I guess you've never been here before. Imagine bustling streets, crystal clean air, and people smiling everywhere you look.
Have you ever seen something like that before, Adam?
Yes. A long time ago. Let's go to where you placed the structure. Excellent. We're almost there. We'll find the Alpha as soon as we get through this place. Do you think you could come down here? We have to open the valve to supply water. Isn't enough water. Hold on. You have to dive down to open a different valve. Should be enough. You can get out by going back to where you started. Finally, outside. See that crater over there? That area is Alpha Nativa territory.
What's a drop pod doing there?
It was abandoned a long time ago. Matter of fact, it's what made this crater.
Wait, that's a 5th Airborne Squad drop pod.
Let's take a closer look. Pretty faint, but I'm picking up a distress signal coming from that drop pod.
That means...
there might still be survivors.
Really?
I can't say for sure, and the Alpha Nativa could appear at any moment. So let's make sure we're well prepared. Let's see what's here.
Wait. I hear something.
Eve, look up! My goodness. I can't believe this.
This is the Alpha Nativa. You can tell by looking at its core.
An Alpha Core. If she were... Eve.
Hmm?
There's something you need to know. The truth is...
Hello? Here! Can somebody rescue me? Please?
Are you the voice?
In the pod.
If you're there, please help. Ah!
What the? A survivor from the airborne squad. Oh.
Were you the one who sent the rescue signal?
Huh? Yes. Yes, it was me. You're a member of the 7th Airborne Squad, right?
Yes. And you?
Right. Let me introduce myself. I'm an engineering support of the 5th Airborne Squad. Lily Artemis II. But you can just call me Lily.
So just to recap, you were in that hideout waiting for another squad to arrive for almost 2 years?
And then you met us.
Yes. Thank you so much for saving me. I've been waiting a long time for the next squad to come in. It's been really lonely here.
It's really lucky we were able to find you when we did.
Eve, you're from the Airborne Squad Assault Force, right?
Yes.
Then I can be your engineering support. Of course, I will need proper equipment first.
Equipment? Well, I did want to say something earlier.
What is it?
Actually, there's a city where other survivors, besides me, live.
What? Really?
It's called Zion, humanity's last city. If we go there, there might be people that can help us. I have a safe house with some equipment I bet you would want.
Then let's head there quickly!
Before that, I would like to ask you something. Currently, Zion is holding out under the guidance of Oracle, who is also our spiritual leader. It's complicated. Eve, I imagine completing your mission isn't any easier having lost your comrades. So, please, help me save Zion. If you do, I promise Oracle and I will do everything we can to help you on your mission. It's about joining forces and helping each other, just like we did before. Sound good?
Yes. Thanks to teamwork, I was able to get the Alpha Call.
Maybe we can get more information in the city, Eve. Think about it.
Yes. I suppose there's no reason to say no. However, I want to decide after hearing the story from that person you're calling Orkel.
That shouldn't be a problem.
Okay, I can definitely get behind that idea.
Well, I guess that settles that. All right then, let's head to Zion.
Yes!
Surprising to see a city in a place like this.
During its prime, over 100,000 people called it home. Obviously, now there are fewer. The place you see below is my safe house. The auxiliary engine's output is weak, so things can get bumpy. Hold on tight.
whole city underneath the wasteland. It's amazing.
Even in the darkest times, it's always safe to bet on human survival instinct.
So, where do we go?
No time for breaks. Typical Eve. Oracle is in the presence chamber. Follow me.